The human brain is an organism that changes itself. Every moment it is changing itself. That's how we become smarter. That's how we learn new skills. That's how we learn to drive cars. It changes itself. Many people have sort of assumed that computer science and the study of human intelligence or learning are totally separate fields. But actually, these fields have been asking the same question about what is the nature of intelligence, and learning is at the heart of what makes intelligence.
So in this project, we're trying to explore kind of the connections and the possible collaborations between machine learning and human learning. In the last couple of years, machine learning has gotten very good so that it can almost be able to, in some cases, learn to do things nearly as well as humans can, for instance. We don't really understand how it works or how to make it better. On the other hand, human learning are sort of our gold standard models for what it means to be a good learner. And we don't really understand how they work as well. And our hope is that by studying these two jointly, not in two separate communities, but in one separate community with one unified set of goals, we might really be able to have both of these areas impact and accelerate progress in the other.
We think, that our whole group thinks, that we can really learn about learning by looking at this, at the development of it. So we put these preschool children into the MRI scanner to measure changes in their brain before and after learning happens. We collect those measurements, and then we can compare the before and after scans to see how the brain changes as children learn in different ways. Probably one of the biggest applications will, of course, it's going to inform us about how people learn. And so I think, practically speaking, hopefully that can inform education.
This is such a special opportunity for Indiana University in particular because we have a strong computer science program, we have people here that are very, very good in machine learning, and we have an extremely strong psychology, cognitive science program with some of the top, very top scientists in the world here. And that unique combination is also in a place that really encourages interdisciplinary collaboration in a way that I haven't necessarily seen in many other universities.
Building this team that is working towards this common goal is something that I find really exciting, and that's what I'm looking forward to the most.
If we learn about visual learning, we can help build satellites and devices that image from cells up to the universe. And we could do a lot for helping people post-stroke, for helping school learning, for helping all forms of human activity. The consequences are huge. And we'd know something deep and true about how learning works.